But what I want to know first is, when you were a young man, why were you sacked from your job at the morgue of Guy's Hospital?
Oh, God, how'd you know about that?
These things.
How on earth? Well,
we have a team of trained monkeys who are researchers, really.
My God. Yes, I was given the job of delivering the drugs on a little train. A little, like, you push the handle down and the train would go with all your drugs in trolleys.
These are legal drugs he's talking about.
These are legal drugs.
Medicinal drugs. We'll get to the trolleys full of the other stuff later.
Yeah. Anyway, so my job was to go in, drive his little truck into the... I can't believe you know this. Drive this truck into the big lifts and take them up and deliver them to the floor where the people needed these... things.
Medications. You were...
Medications. I needed these.
How old were you with this kind of responsibility?
16.
You were 16? They gave you a cart full of drugs?
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, this is negligence.
Yeah,
okay,
well, this is NHS in its worst form, but bless them, because they gave me a little truck to drive around on. I mean, that's any 16-year-old. Just to drive around on a little truck like that was cool. Anyway... There was a bleeding bar on the ground floor right by the morgue where you parked your truck, right? Right. Okay. There was a bar there.
Guy's Hospital.
I don't care who knows it now. Guy's Hospital had a bar. So I'd park my truck up, my little truck with all the thing.
So you're driving around a mini train full of drugs.
Mini train, yeah.
And you end up at the bar next to the morgue.
With me train.
With your truck, of course. And you park up and you go into the bar. What did you have?
A light owl.
A light owl.
Yeah. In them days, I don't know if they still do them. A bottle of light owl.
Pete, do you have any idea what he's talking about?
Yes,
he just went into Swahili.
He don't know what a light owl is. Yeah, a little bottle, what you would call a dark beer.
Oh, fantastic. I'm a big fan of the dark beer.
Yeah.
And this is the cure for what ails me. You see what I did there? Okay, sorry.
I see what you did there.
Okay, sorry.
Anyway, a dark owl.
How did you get fired?
But it was called a light owl. So I went in there.
Dark ale is light owl. Keep up, folks.
And, of course, I'm seen in there, or someone, as we say, grassed me up being in there with me truck, with me... What do we just call them things?
Carriages.
Carriages. Carriages. And that was me lot. So I got done because
you were fired for drinking at the bar of the hospital that you worked next to the morgue.
No, I was done, what it's now called, I was done for being in the bar
during your hours of employment.
No, because I had the drugs on me. What's the word?
Possession?
Possession.
Possession with intent to distribute. Oh my God.
Yeah. It's actually on there.
Possession with intent to distribute in a morgue.
Not in the morgue. No, hang on. We've got to get the morgue thing right.
Sorry.
Because they couldn't sack me outright because I was in possession of these drugs by a drunk. Even though I only had a light owl, they had to keep me. Oh, please keep them listening. They had to keep me on, so they gave me a job in the morgue to try and, you know, break my character.
So, how was your job? How did you enjoy your job at the morgue?
I used to say to everyone, I mean, it was weird. I mean, like, my God, it was very weird. Cause,
well, you were 16, so these were your first dead bodies.
Yeah, and I looked after about, it must have been 100, 200 dead bodies.
Were you ever
in my time I was there before they got rid of me.
Terry, were you ever tempted?
I tell you what, it's a weird thing.
I
don't want to put anyone in it, but there were people that did weird things, man.
See, I could never do that for fear of getting
We did sit them all up. We did sit all the dead bodies up for a photo thing We did sit them up. That's all we did, though.
Okay. Yeah. You didn't dress
a tea party thing, all right?
All right, folks. This is an esteemed writer and author.
can we cut this stuff out?
Yeah. Someone who's traveled with and written about some of the biggest rock stars on our planet, and we're talking vaguely about necrophilia.
No, that's really out of order.
Which is bang out of order, as they say. So we're going to move swiftly somehow.
We set them up. All we did was sit them up with notes on them.
So before you worked with the dead, you also worked with some of our most famous living. And some even...
I'm not getting off this dead thing. All we did was sit them up at a tea party and took a photograph.
So what we're saying is you worked with some of the photographed dead. And after that, you worked with some of the photographed living, and some may say, regarding Keith Richards, you've even worked with some of the living dead.